Welcome to the Pet Show on Tualatin Valley Cable TV. I'm Kathy Covey, your host. Today I'm joined with Dr. Kathryn Utsey from Crossroads Veterinary Hospital, and we're going to talk about New Year's resolutions. You know you're going to make them, and I want to give you a good reason to keep them. The best reason is that they will benefit your pet. So first I want to talk to you about the number one resolution that a lot of people are going to make right now, and that is to stop smoking. We all know why it's good for us. Let me know why it's good for your pet.
Well, cats and dogs suffer from some of the same problems that people who are exposed to secondhand smoke suffer from. Some different things happen with cats and dogs, though, especially cats. Secondhand smoke, the toxins from it, actually settle on their coat. And they lick it off.
So when they're cleaning themselves, mm-hmm. they're getting it.
They're ingesting it.
Ooh.
So cats are actually four times more likely to develop something called oral squamous cell carcinoma of the mouth, which is
wow.
a horrible cancer that's very locally invasive, not very treatable
wow.
because the mouth is a difficult area to surgically remove tumors from. And cats who are exposed to secondhand smoke are four times more likely to develop that than a cat that lives in a smoke-free household.
Wow.
So that's pretty serious. Cats are also 2 to 3 times more likely to develop lymphoma, which is a cancer of the lymph nodes, if they live in a smoking household. We also have cats that suffer more asthma. For dogs, you see more chronic airway disease, such as coughing. In dogs, you see more nasal tumors, as well as possibly more lung cancer. So it's very serious in pets.
So. Stop smoking
yes.
for the benefit of your pet. Mm-hmm. That's amazing. I lived in a house with a smoker. My father was a chronic smoker, and we had cats. And I had no idea at the time that my cats would be basically inhaling and licking
yes.
the smoke at the same time.
Yes.
That's pretty serious. So
yes.
I tell you, if you smoke, really might want to look at your pet, look into your pet's eyes, and that might give you a better reason to stop smoking.
Absolutely.
Today's pet tip, schedule your pet's annual vet visit. And Dr. Utsey, why is that important?
Well, it's really nice to take a look at your pet at least once a year. We examine them from nose to toes, looking for anything unusual, anything that's changed. You know, we're listening to the heart, trying to find a heart murmur, palpating the abdomen, feeling for masses, things like that. And then also looking at their vaccination status, which is pretty important. There's been mm-hmm. a couple of cases of parvovirus recently in the Portland area.
Okay.
And quite a few rabid bats
wow.
Found in Oregon. A couple in Multnomah County, one in Washington County in 2012. So rabies is definitely a concern around here.
And rabies vaccine might not be something that every pet owner would get for their cat or even their dog, because it's not required. If you don't have to license your pet, it's technically not required.
Right.
But you're saying that it's a good idea because we're starting to see more rabies maybe
yes.
coming into the Portland
mm-hmm.
area.
Definitely. Especially those outdoor cats. It's really important.
So, everyone, schedule your pet's vet visit today. Now, top of everybody's New Year's resolution list, including mine, is exercise. Recently, I discovered that over 50% of dogs and cats are either overweight or obese. What can we do? How can we prevent that? How can you get your pet to exercise?
Well, first, just like in people, obesity in animals can cause some serious health concerns.
Mm-hmm.
Dogs that are already prone to arthritis makes arthritis worse. Brachycephalic animals, which are the kind of animals that have the smushed face, like bulldogs, Persian cats, have more breathing problems
mm-hmm.
when they're overweight. And then there was a study done recently on Labrador retrievers where they took some overweight retrievers and some normal weight to slender retrievers, and they followed them through their lifespans, and the slender dogs were 2.5 lived a median of 2.5 years longer than the overweight dogs.
So it can be pretty serious if your pet's overweight.
Yes.
And when a pet's overweight, it's not you know, like the 10 pounds. It could just be a pound.
Yes. So like a cat that's a pound overweight is, you know, anywhere from 5 to 10 pounds overweight to a person. So it's a much bigger deal. If you think about a cat being only a 10-pound animal, usually, yeah, you know, 1 pound makes a big difference.
And, you know, I found another piece of information. I actually had to write it down here because it's a lot of numbers in it. A 19-pound cat, which is about 9 pounds overweight from the average cat, is equivalent to a 5'4" woman weighing 276 pounds or being 131 pounds overweight.
Yeah.
That's pretty serious. And then there was also like a smaller dog, like a cocker type dog, weighing 48 pounds is like a 5'9" man weighing 368 pounds, which is about 199 pounds overweight.
Yeah. And the cat and dog, just like those obese people, are more prone to diabetes too.
That's some serious health concerns.
Yeah.
So what can somebody do to help their pet lose weight?
Well, exercise, definitely. Just like people, exercise is very important in animals. So if you're starting a new routine with your dog, though, you want to be careful. Just like a person who's out of shape, you don't go running for 5 miles straight out the door. You want to work your way up to it.
Okay.
So same thing with your dog. And your cat, too, especially if you have an indoor cat, they tend to not get as much exercise. So a laser pointer, or one of those cat fishing pole toys, a great way to play with your cat, bond with them a little bit, and get them some exercise.
And what about food?
Food. So you want to be very careful. Oftentimes, the guidelines on the food bags are a little overly generous because no food company wants your cat to get skinny on their food. You know, they don't want you to blame them for having a skinny cat. So you want to be a little bit careful with the guidelines on the bag, and you want to use an actual measuring cup.
Really?
When you're feeding. Yes, a lot of people find are using, you know, a coffee cup or something like that, and they don't know actually how much they're actually feeding their pet.
And so, what about those of us like myself that free feed?
Again, you want to be feeding a certain amount each day. So if you're free feeding, you should be still measuring at the beginning of the day.
Okay.
And when they've gone through it, that's it.
And this is the same as, you know, cutting out the treats, you know, doing the same type of things that you or I would do to lose a couple pounds.
Exactly. And I find that in households with large families, sometimes we don't know how many treats the animal is getting.
Because the son's giving treats, the daughter, then the husband doesn't think the dog's gotten a treat yet,
right,
and giving him a treat.
Yep. So it's a good idea at the beginning of each day, have a little jar or something. You put you put a certain number of treats in it. That's all the treats the animal is allowed to have for the day. And when it's gone, it's gone. And that way everyone knows they're getting the right amount of treats, not too many.
Great. So it should inspire not only for you to help your pet lose weight, but maybe for you to take some steps and lose weight as well.
Yeah.
Utsey is a big hunk of love. He loves people very much and will insist on getting some attention from them. He's quite the soccer player and would love a home where he can chase plastic balls all over the place. Come meet him at Cats Adoption Center inside the Tualatin Petco store.
Finally, a lot of us try to clean out and clean up for the New Year's, making that one of our resolutions. Toss out the old, bring in the new. If you're tempted to clean out your cupboards or your cabinets of cleaning products, medication, really want to take some extra steps to make sure your pet doesn't get into those. So let's talk about cleaning products, because I know underneath my cabinet, underneath my sink, I've got a lot of things that I use around the house to clean. So we want to, if we could clean it out, we want to replace it with pet-friendly, safe items, because dogs and cats will get into them.
Yes, definitely. And, you know, these products that have bleach in them, if a dog or a cat ingests it, they can have some pretty serious problems, ulceration of the esophagus, etc. Also, the little insert you put in the back of the toilet to make the water blue, you don't want them drinking out of that. You can have some problems with that,
really?
Too.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Mm-hmm. So, you know, replacing them with some pet-friendly cleaners. I know some people use vinegar for cleaning windows and mirrors and things like that, baking soda-based products as well. And then for cleaning pet messes, enzymatic cleaners like Nature's Miracle.
Great, mm-hmm. Great. And then what about the medical cabinet? You know, my vitamin I and Sudafed mm-hmm. are prominent in a lot of people's mm-hmm. cabinet.
Yep.
But yet, I understand these aren't as good for your pet as they are for us.
Yeah, definitely not. NSAIDs like ibuprofen, naproxen sodium, which is Aleve, mm-hmm. Even the prescription ones like piroxicam, they can cause some pretty serious health issues in dogs, such as liver damage, kidney damage, serious GI ulceration, even perforation of the stomach, which you can imagine is a very, very bad thing.
Wow.
Also, acetaminophen mm-hmm. Can cause problems in both cats and dogs. Liver failure, just something you don't want them to have access to.
So when you clear out underneath the sink and you clear out your medicine cabinet of everything that's maybe expired or old, you should go right out into the garbage.
Yes, absolutely.
So the dog or cat mm-hmm. does not get into them.
Yep.
Now, what are some other things that people might find under their sink that maybe they didn't realize they had that could be toxic that they either need to get out from under their sink, they need to get out of their garage as they're cleaning up to help their dog and cat?
Well, things like antifreeze. Antifreeze causes kidney failure.
And that's all syrupy sweet mm-hmm. and beautiful.
Yes.
I know there have been mm-hmm. some issues with that.
Yes.
They're trying to make it,
it tastes,
put a
right.
bitterer in
mm-hmm.
it.
Exactly. Right now it tastes really good. So there's been some people trying to make regulations where they add a bittering agent so it no longer tastes good to animals, which I think is a great idea since it's very deadly. Another thing is rat or mouse poison.
Okay.
These are formulated to taste good to rats and mice. They often have a grain base, and it's something that dogs like the taste of as well.
Wow.
The older poisons, they cause clotting problems with the blood, so dogs can bleed to death internally. This is something that, if it's caught early, can often be remedied with vitamin K. But some of the newer products are a little bit harder. Some of them cause neurologic symptoms. We have some that cause hypercalcemia, which is an increase of calcium in the body, which
okay.
can cause organ damage. So you really want to get that out of your house.
Now, one other thing, one other place that you might be thinking of cleaning up, and that's your purse.
Mm-hmm.
There are some things, you know, if you just leave your purse hanging around, there are some things in your purse that, you know, besides the little container of ibuprofen that mm-hmm, you might have in
right.
there, but there's some little things in your purse that I didn't realize were attractive to your pet that could really cause some problems.
Mm-hmm. Yes, specifically anything that contains xylitol, which is an artificial sweetener.
Okay.
So it's most commonly found in sugar-free gum. And this is a very serious toxin, especially to dogs. It causes hypoglycemia, which is very low blood sugar. It can cause liver damage, and in some cases has even killed dogs.
Wow, so if you're cleaning out your purse, or you leave your purse out, you might want to make it your resolution to put your purse up high if you've got mm-hmm. this sugar-free gum in there.
Yeah.
Well, I want to thank you, Dr. Utsey, for joining me today and talking about some things that we can do to make sure that we keep our resolutions, because they're not only good for us, they're good for your pet. If you want more information about anything that we've talked about, go to catadoptionteam.org/petshow. We'll see you next time.